I want to make sure I go the right way here. So that earthquake just opened up what was... That actually opened up this area that we just went through. This is the one little, like, sequence break in the game. You can go here before you're supposed to. Well, I should... Let me rephrase. It's the one useful sequence break in the game. I believe there are a couple other places where you can... Where you can do this, but it doesn't really, it doesn't really matter, essentially. How would the nest be goldenized? Goldenized? I don't think that's a word, but whatever. Oops. Ouch. Game, please. And hello, Sobura. And Gamma Metroid, oh no! One of the nice things about 100% is that there's no need for tactics. You can just, like, war of attrition pretty much every time. Also, there's a missile neutral damage, I think. Hey, Driver 3000, how are ya? Alright, so now we're gonna go to actually where we were supposed to go when the Metroid count read 16. And the reason we do this first is because it saves a little bit of backtracking. And you like not having to backtrack. I like not having to backtrack. Okay, so you'd just be painting it gold. I want to say, wasn't a gold N64 actually a thing that Nintendo offered at one point? I want to say, like, for one of the Zeldas. Pew-pew. Firing up lightning beam. Okay. Yeah, I would say the buyable gold N64 just because it was actually a thing that people were doing, if that makes any sense. Whereas with the gold NES, I feel like you're just gonna get people asking, well, why did you paint a perfectly good NES? Maybe that's just me. Dude, gas music. This is awesome. Metroid, till they're dead and exterminated. So the way that I named, like, the phases is mainly what Nintendo Power did back in, like, issue 30-something. But, I basically combined two of the phases into one. Ow. Ow. Game, please. Bloop, 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 bloop. I mean, but that's just me. Maybe on the other hand, people would like the golden NES precisely because you can't buy such a thing. I'm not sure where I think I am cool. Not even that close to where I think I am cool, frankly. I don't like how you can quickly take damage in here. I wouldn't know, Zio. I never, like, had one. Try to can't get it much better. That's that. There's gonna be another split coming up. So right now we're looking good to beat my TV. I don't know about cutting the two. I love that turn of phrase. It was apparently a Japanese thing. I don't know if it was just a bad translation or what, but to cut the X means basically you gotta time below that. So yeah, the see-through colored ones are pretty cool. Definitely. Oops. I like these guys because they give lots of energy. They give big pellets. Also, hello, Ducks Cub. Alright, here we go. Phase 7. Or Phase 6, as I call it. I combined the Nintendo Power Phases 5 and 6 into 1. Because I actually do Phase 6 before Phase 1. That's what that dip into the lava is. Dropping bombs. Alright, so we'll get the final two E-tanks and the final four missile tanks. So it'll give us 250 missiles. Six E-tanks, even though we can only hold five. This is the one and only place in the game where you have to use missiles to box it all over. Also, the thing I like is that for the most part, the ambiance within each of the phases proper, I think, has actually changed slightly from phase to phase. So that's pretty cool. Alright, so that's right, there's a random Gamma Metroid just hanging out here. Yep, Gamma. We're gonna come up here next. And the spikes are kind of your way. The way of saying, no getting up here without the space jump for you, buddy. So I think I mentioned, Alpha Metroids take 5 missiles, Gamma Metroids take 10. Looking. Zeta Metroids take 20 missiles to kill. This one, however, you fight, and for the most part, very easy. They're quick.
They can hurt you if you're not careful.
Alright, so now we're going up here. Oops, nope. Take that back. Going this way. Yeah, I mean, it's not like, you know, they were cloned or anything later in the series, either. Alright, so now we come up here. Here? Yes, okay, so we go down here, grab a missile expansion. Going up here. Gamma Metroid, and again, on tiny platforms, and if we screw up, you fall all the way down. Basically, up to the again, the one bit of good news for people doing 100% run, I basically have the energy to spare. And another little bit of good news is if we go over here, turns out there's an energy refill here. which I'm somewhat redundantly taking advantage of. Screwed that up, dude. Nice job. Man. Go up here next. Missile recharge. Should have 220.
Yep. Okay.
So I want to continue going up this way, in other words. Ow, game, please. So hopefully everybody is enjoying my stumbling my way through this. I apologize, I'm not a little more sure of where to navigate just yet. Hopefully I'll get there. Zetas, like I said, take 20 missiles, and you can't... The kind of evil thing about Zetas is that you can't shoot them from the left. You have to hit them from the left. And they have this, like, not all we get over here, though. Get up there, Samus, please. There we go. I'm going the wrong way. Okay, yeah, I know that there's some, this is not necessarily an optimal 100%. So I'm still kind of warming my way through it. So we get one of our final major upgrades, the screw attack. So we're now invincible, basically. Screw attack, yes! The crazy thing is, this is actually not an NES game, it's actually a Game Boy game, an original Game Boy game. I'm playing it on the Game Boy Player, which is why there's a little bit of color. But, as I mentioned before, I feel like this is the game that marks kind of a turning point.
Like... where am I? Okay, yeah.
Like, where after this game was where, like, the developers for the Game Boy really started to, like, work their magic with it. Like, if you compare Super Mario Land to Super Mario Land 2, it's like they're made for two different systems. So, huh, that's a weird place for a new tank. Wouldn't you agree? Come down here. A fifth energy tank. Hooray! That's not all. We're gonna come here now.
Did I go this way? I don't believe I did.